Hello everybody and welcome back to another Fallout 76 video. In today's video I'm going to be teaching you how to make a UFO base. This thing is absolutely insane. Just look at it right now. I mean, that's crazy. You're going to need a couple things. You're going to need a friend, or you can use a flamethrower trap. You're going to want to stack it onto and some kind of object and be able to destroy something, because it requires you to destroy things and use that object being invisible because it's destroyed to place a different object that would usually clip into it. I'm also going to break this video into four parts. I'm going to break it into the circle part to make the actual circle and the shape of the UFO. I'm going to break it into the second part, which will be how to build the floating walls. The third part will be how to do the bottom. And then the fourth part will be the roof. So let's get into this video. Hope you enjoy it. So once you found your base location that's relatively flat and you have your buddy, you're going to want to build in a formation of foundations like this in the flat area. Make sure they're all the same length. You're going to want to go a concrete foundation in the middle, and then on each four sides of that you're going to want to go out two foundations. And then once we do that, we can start doing the walls and doing the circle of the base. So now what you're going to want to do is you're going to delete the ones that have a gap from the foundation right in the middle, like so, to where you have these foundations on the outer sides and there's a little gap. So they're perfectly lined up. Everything's perfect. You want to get out your walls and place them on all four, with the walls of the inside of the walls facing inward towards the middle foundation. Now you have the decision whether you want the walls that go around your UFO, if you want them to be full walls or if you want them to be half walls. The cons of a full wall is you're gonna have to build it higher off the ground, so then you have to build probably stairs in order to get up into it, because you won't be able to jump up in there. Or but you also have more room obviously in the full walls, so if you were looking for room, that's probably the way to go. But with the half wall, you can build it smaller, it looks slimmer. And maybe the smaller wall is more like a battleship, and then the thicker wall is more of a mothership. But with the thinner wall, you're obviously going to have less ceiling space, and so you're not going to be able to put things right up against the wall. So the half wall is also, it's another step that you have to add to it. So it's really up to you whether you want to do it, but the beginning stage is basically the same. So what you're going to want to do after that is you want to come over to the foundation. Once you've decided which one you want to do, that's how you're gonna continue from this. So you're gonna wanna go in third person and make sure you have the foundation, because it has the little cross section in the middle. You're gonna wanna line up your character as close as you can to right in the middle of that cross, because it's detrimental that you line your character up perfectly as close to the middle as you can, because if you're off-centered, your circle's gonna be off-centered. And then you're going to want to probably change your foundation to the regular wood one, so you can see the line in the middle. You're going to want to put your crosshair as close to exactly the middle as you can. You want to grab it, and you want to turn without lowering it, like this, until it's right at the edge, right there. Then you're going to go into your inventory, get out another wall, hold down A, and then push forward on your left stick, and then you're going to place it. And then you'll place that one. You'll go back down, grab the foundation, turn, place it again, hold A or X, and then push on the left stick forward, and then place it down. And you want to rinse and repeat that. This one right here, you're going to want to delete. That'll stay. You want to come back to this foundation, grab it, and turn it. Try to line it up as close as possible, right about there, and then you want to keep doing it. You need to do this all in one continuous take, because if you get off of this, then you're going to mess up the align. So do you see how I made all five of these all while standing still? You need to do that all the way around. Once you've done that and you've connected everything, you should have something like this. It should look exactly like this. Everything will be connected up perfectly. The lines on the outer side, there shouldn't be any gaps like this. And now that we're moving on to the wall, you're going to want to make sure to take on wherever you have the foundation, you're going to want to bring out one more foundation on the outside, so it's like this. Then you want to grab the one on the inside, bring it over to here, put another foundation on the outside, and then continue to do that all the way around. So then the foundations are on the outside of the walls. Make sure that when you do this, once you're done with doing this, do not ever, until you're completely done with the build, remove these foundations. If you remove these foundations, you have to restart the entire base build. Keep in mind, you have to keep these foundations here. If you delete them, you screw up the entire thing. There's no saving it. So make sure, once you place these down, just be careful when you're hovering over them or anywhere near them to not delete them. Once you have the foundations laid on the outside of all of these walls, it is safe to delete the foundation in the middle because you're not going to be making any more circles. Now, it comes in where that the decision you made of whether you want a full wall or a half wall, that's where this comes in. So in order to make a full wall, it's a lot easier. What you're going to want to do is place a doorway, another doorway, and then another doorway on top of that. Then delete, delete. And now you have a floating doorway. And later you could just press replace and then change what kind of doors on there and it'll stay floating. For the half wall, this is a little bit longer. You're going to want to put doorway, half wall, then you're going to want to put another half wall. Then on the other side of this foundation, you want to bring it up two doorways. So now you have a doorway, half wall, half wall, half wall, and a parallel to that, two doorways. Then you're going to want to grab a half wall, place it on top of the two doorways, go to roofs, pull out the flat one, make sure that the lines are going across this way and they're not going parallel to the two roofs. This is really matters, the roof placement. It really matters. Then you'll be able to hover over the half wall in the middle. You'll be able to scrap it, then scrap the roof, and then scrap the rest of this one right here. Delete this half wall and then leave that half wall right there, that doorway right there, and then you have it floating. So once you decide whether you want to do a full wall or a half wall, I'm going to do a half wall for the sake of this video. You want to take one foundation, place it right in front of the door. Then you want to go to walls. Don't place that one there. You want to place a doorway and a doorway. So then you have three right there. You want to scrap the middle. And then now you have a floating full wall. Then you want to move the foundation to right here. One, two, scrap. This isn't necessary, but I like to do this so I know which one I'm doing at the moment. You don't have to move this one with it, but just do doorway, doorway, scrap. Okay, so once you're done with the floating ring, the entire thing should look exactly like this. It should be floating. Now, moving on to the part of the bottom. This is the second step. You're going to have your friend here now. You're going to want to go to the first wall you're wanting to start, and you're going to want to press scrap, replace, and make it a full wall. Like so. You're going to want to then go on the outside of the ring, and you want to go to roofs, and go to the slanted roof. It is going to then snap to the outside. Then you go onto the inside, and then snap directly to that roof. Now, you have a floating object that does not allow you to delete it. You're not going to be able to delete this one, and you're not going to be able to delete this one. So, what you need to do is have your friend aggro you. So, punch your friend, and have him punch you. And now, he can destroy the inner roof, right there. So now, in your building menu, you're going to see the yellow roof, right there. So then, you're going to take two foundations, and build it out. Two, like so. Then you're gonna want to build up a doorway, not a full wall. A doorway, and then another doorway. Then you're gonna want to take a roof. Make sure that the lines are facing, they're going from the wall towards the other wall. They want to be facing this direction, it matters. Then you can delete this middle one, and then delete this wall, and then get the flat roof back out, and then now you have two roofs right there. Then you'll have your buddy destroy those two. Like so. Then what you want to do is go back down to your sloped roof and turn it until you snap right there, and then have your buddy destroyed again. Okay, now you're going to want to delete this, delete these two foundations. And then on the outside, you're going to want to take a floor. Well, I can't do it right here, so you have to do it on the inside. So I'll build out three so you don't have any snapping issues. When you're deleting the one on the outside, make sure that you're not building up a wall that's going to be lined up with this. You have to go out three. Now, I'm going to build up a floor or a doorway, doorway, doorway all the way up there. Get your roofs, flat ones. Make sure that they're facing the right way. And then you want to continue that all the way over to the full roof. What that does is it grounds it and makes it to where this is not a floating object. Then you can scrap that. Then you come over here, scrap these flat roofs. All the way across. And then you can scrap the foundations. And then you're done with the bottom part of your first ring. Now, you want to repeat that process on every single side all the way around. Do it in that order exactly. You can rewind the video, rewatch it as many times as you want. Okay, so I'm reached about, if I do one more face, it's going to be exactly halfway. But the way you were doing the foundations on the inside, if you continue to do that, the third wall, the third foundation where you build up the three walls and go across to get rid of the outside roof, if you build that up, it will snap to the opposite side, and then you'll have a really big mess up over here. So in order to fix that and not have to deal with that, the wall that you're about to do, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to come out to do these like normal, but don't come out a third one. You want to take that and come out here and build one foundation out here. Then you'll be able to build up three from out here on the outside, and then do the same exact thing. You'll be able to build across like so. Not like that. You want to build the flat one right here, and then you'll be able to build or delete the sloped roof right here. Do not build three out once you've hit the halfway point. You can build on the inside until you get about halfway, but if I did this one right here, when I would build up the three, it would snap to right here, and then these roofs would not be, I would not be able to delete the walls to get rid of it, because these roofs would be attached to it, and then these would be inaccessible. So just make sure you do them on the outside and everything is going to go smooth and you'll be all right. All right, when you're done with everything, the bottom of it should look like this. You should be no inconsistencies. There shouldn't be any gaps. When you look up directly through the middle, each one of these little edges, there should be about 16 of them, and they should be exactly the same length. On top, there shouldn't be anything missing either. And so when you're done with that, you can start to delete these doorways. Do not delete the foundations. Delete the doorways to give yourself a little bit more room. Then try to go over to your camp thing and do repair all. Mine's a little glitched right now, but repair all. Okay, so once you're able to repair all, since I'm in a workshop, I had to repair each one individually, but you will be able to, if you're building this at your camp, which you should be, you should be able to walk over to your camp little loadout thingy and press repair all, and it all pop up, already done. So now that we have this, you can kind of see the basic little, you know, shape of it. So now, in order to get into it, there's a couple ways that you can do. If you want, you could place a foundation roughly in the middle, like this, and you can place a kind of staircase right here, and then you could just attach a floor to this, right there. And you just do a little bit of like lining up and stuff like that, and then you could just walk up here, get on here, and then just jump into it. You could change this into a doorway like that, then you can use the foundation that's at the bottom, and then you can build out, and then you can build up a staircase and plinth a floor right here. That's what my buddy did. But me, for this, the sake of this video, I'm gonna be using a symptomatic. You can also use a symptomatic. You could put a symptomatic right at the edge. Go over to misstruction. Oh, I'm sneaking through something. You go to misstructures, and then you place a symptomatic as close as possible to the edge. You wanna, the goal is to have a little bit of the symptomatic hanging off the edge, like this. So then you can remove this, go out of it. You look up, you jump, and then try to enter it. I'm not gonna do that one actually. I'm gonna just keep the basic floor. Alright, now for the roof, it's the same concept as the ground, but it's a lot easier because there's fewer steps. So I'm gonna go ahead and place this floor down. Go ahead and place this one back down, so if I fall off, I can just get back up. What you're gonna wanna do is grab your roof, sloped roof, like this. You wanna place it. You wanna go to your flat one, and you're gonna wanna build over two. Like that. You're gonna have your buddy destroy it. All three. Okay. Then you're gonna wanna move on to the next one. Like this. You're gonna wanna connect. Right about, it's a little finicky. There you go, have him destroy the next three. And you just rinse and repeat that all the way around. Once you start getting to the opposite side, like once you start getting, once you make a full circle and you're building right here, you gotta remember that you still have the middle one connected to this one right here, right? So have him destroy those two. Well, this one's a little bit unaligned, so I can actually squeeze another one in there. Go ahead and destroy that one too. Okay. Then you just continue to do it over and over again. Once you're done going completely around the edges and having your friend destroy them, you want to go to your camp and you want to repair all. In my opinion, what you should do next is go to your floor decor and your building menu and go over to something that's called the Enclave Medallion. You can get these by completing daily ops. It's a random drop for the rare reward. You got to complete it under 8 minutes. And then I would place these down on as much as the floor as you can, and then cover up all this clipping because it can strain your eyes and it's a little ugly, right? And so if you spark some creativity and you can build whatever you want in here, maybe you could pull something off like this. Once you're done with the interior, the roof, and the bottom, now you're done. You're done with the structure. What you can do is you can now destroy each one of these foundations. Before you do this, I would recommend going through the entire build and making sure that you haven't missed anything. Because once you delete these, there's no going back. You're done. If you have deleted these and you have any holes in the floor on the top inside, you can place down rugs to cover up the hole. As a quick fix in case you don't want to redo it. Say you're up here and you realize, oh no, like one of these flat pieces are missing, like right here. You can take one of the the Enclave Medallions and you can place it right over the hole and it'll look like it's never there. But just make sure before you delete anything, go throughout everything and make sure you have two right here, everything. Make sure you're good. Look at the bottom. Make sure everything is clipping correctly and there's one on every single face and on the inside also, and then you can start deleting the foundations. I want to give a special thanks to my buddy Xtron420. He sat here for numerous hours and helped me create the video. I'd also like to mention that for all the people that made the half wall, you can do, or even the full wall, this is what you're gonna do. You can add a turret like tucked in its own little bay, and you'll have the roof that kind of comes out and it looks like a shutter door, or you know, it swings open in the turrets there, and it'll defend your base, and it'll look like your UFO is armed, right? So what you want to do to build this is you want to come over here, build your floating half wall. So doorway, wall, half wall, half wall. Then one away from that, door, door. Then roof across, delete the middle one, delete this one, delete the roof, and then delete the rest of these. Then it's the same process. You're going to want to add that. You're going to do this, and then you're going to have your buddy destroy it. We're not aggroed. Okay, then he's going to destroy the middle piece. Then you're going to come over here, build up, then a half wall, and across two, delete the middle, delete that, place it back, have him destroy those two. Then you're going to want to get that right in there, have him destroy that piece. Okay. Then you're going to need to go three out, or on the outside, you're going to go up two. You're going to connect the roof all the way across. But instead of deleting the outside, you can't delete the outside, and then you won't be able to delete that, right? So you have to leave the outside in order to delete the inside. So in you'll build across, and the outside won't be right there. You're going to want to delete this one, okay? You're going to delete this one. Then you're going to move on to doing two. So what you would want to do is you would have the little cubby where the turret would be, like this, and then you would have a full one, do it regularly, and then have another regular one, and then do another cubby, and then have a full one, turret, full one, turret, full one, turret, and you just keep doing that all the way around. It's an even build, so it'll line up perfectly, and your UFO will be armed, and then you have a open and close weapon. I mean, it's sick. I'd like to take this moment to thank everybody for getting this far throughout the video. Leave a comment, tell me if you like this build, and tell me if it went good for you. Hopefully you're able to do it, no problem. You know, like, subscribe, and have a good one, you scrubs.